Hello, Panthers. I'm your host, Vivi, and it's been a wonderful week. Remember, today is a half day. Now, let's check out Panther Paws.
Hi, Panthers. I'm Ms. Jackson, one of the assistant principals here. And with me today, I have our student of the week, Dakota Pringle. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Dakota she exhibits all the traits of an avid student leader. She's a model student, and not only just for avid, but for all of seventh grade, because she gets her work in on time and she makes sure that she understands it. She asks questions. She is just a great model student, and we appreciate having her on campus. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hello, Panther Nation. This is Mr. Marion, Assistant Principal, and I'm joined today by Mr. Hudson, our PABS para. And we're here today to recognize Mr. Hudson as our Panther Spotlight of the Week. Mr. Hudson has been doing a great job, has jumped in, has been serving on campus. He has been serving in the breakfast during the morning, coming in during lunch at 6th, 7th, 8th grade lunch, and building relationships with students and throughout the day supporting students. And Mr. Hudson, we just wanted to say thank you for the way you support NAVO and are building relationships with our students. So how does this make you feel being recognized as our Spotlight of the Week?
Surprised. I wasn't expecting this, but I appreciate it. I really appreciate it.
So thank you again, Mr. Hudson, for supporting NAVO.
Hi, my name is Savira, and this is the new staff highlight. Right here with me, I have Ms. Gibson. Ms. Gibson, what brought you to NAVO?
What brought me to NAVO was I always passed by it. I always was curious about the school and decided to see if there was an opening for this school. And I was fortunate enough to get the receptionist position.
What do you like about it?
I love the staff, that it's everybody's friendly. The kids are very friendly. Everyone has been very welcoming, even the parents. So that is, I feel like I have made a new family here at NAVO.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
My name is Kaylee, and welcome to College and Career Corner. And today I'm interviewing Mr. Seals. Mr. Seals, what is the college that you went to?
So I went to Texas A&M University Commerce. It's a sister school of the Texas A&M system.
And why did you go to that college?
I went to that college because it was close enough to still get home when I needed to, but far enough to where my parents didn't pop up all the time.
What is a good memory from college?
Honestly, my favorite memory, being done with school at noon every day was wonderful. So, I fully, highly suggest kids go to college. It's worth it.
Thank you.
Hi, Panthers. I'm Ms. Jackson, one of the assistant principals at NAVO Middle School. And I have with me an avid student, Dakota. How are you doing, Dakota?
I'm good.
Good. She is here for our avid moment. And so, we're just going to ask a few questions. Dakota, why did you choose avid?
I chose AVID because of the collaborative work that we do, and it's just a really fun place to be in.
Okay. And what do you enjoy most about being in AVID?
I like that we have a lot of time to do our work, and we get to talk a lot, and it's just a place to be yourself.
And what do you look forward to in AVID for the future?
I look forward to all the projects and the new stuff we get to learn.
All right. Thank you so much, Dakota.
You're welcome.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
Hooking up words and phrases and clauses.
Conjunction, junction, how's that function?
I got three favorite cards that get most of my job done.
Conjunction, junction, what's their function?
I got and, but, and, or, they'll get you pretty far. And, that's an additive, like this and that. But, that's sort of the opposite, not this, but that. And then there's or, O-R.
Junction, what's your function?
Hooking up two boxcars and making them run right. Milk and honey, bread and butter, peas and rice.
Hey, that's nice.
Dirty but happy, digging and scratching, losing your shoe and a button or two. He's poor but honest, sad but true. Boo!
Junction, what's your function?
Hooking up two cars to one when you say something like this. Choice, either now or later, or no choice. Neither now nor ever.
Hey, that's clever.
Eat this or that, to grow thin or fat. Never mind, I wouldn't do that, I'm fat enough now.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
Hooking up phrases and clauses that balance like out of the frying pan and into the fire. He cut loose the sandbags, but the balloon wouldn't go any higher. Let's go up to the mountains or down to the seas. You should always say thank you or at least say please.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
Hooking up words and phrases and clauses in complex sentences like in the mornings when I'm usually wide awake, I love to take a walk through the gardens and down by the lake, where I often see a duck and a drake. And I wonder as I walk by just what they'd say if they could speak, although I know that's an absurd thought.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
Hooking up cars and making them function.
Conjunction, junction, how's that function?
I like tying up words and phrases and clauses.
Conjunction, junction, watch that function.
I'm gonna get you there if you're very careful.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
I'm going to get you there if you're very careful.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
I'm going to get you there.
Hi, I'm Lincoln. Next week, we're playing Aubrey at Aubrey. Come and check us out.
I'm on the 8th grade volleyball team. Come and watch us play Celina at Celina next week. Wish us luck.
Hello, everybody, Mr. Brown with the Choose Well program, and today I want to talk about responsibility. Recently, I made a series, a whole series on responsibility. It was called I Choose Responsibility, and we did this because we talked about growing up and being strong, and that's your responsibility, to grow up and take care of yourself. So we're going to talk about responsibility. We're going to talk about it in a different way when it comes to this idea of self-discipline. Now, let me explain. Growing up, I was like this car. This is a remote control Batmobile. This is pretty cool. I got this for my 9th year anniversary. It has nothing to do with anniversary. Neither one of us are really Batman fans. I've never seen Batman. I do have a question about Batman. Why is Batman and Superman fighting? I mean, that's just wrong. Like, what happened to the Justice League? Anyway, this is a Batmobile my wife got me. She got it for me because my son had saw it the week before and he was so excited to get it. In our marriage, she was saying that, hey, we're being generous. Well, this remote control reminds me of when I was growing up, because as a kid, I could make a lot of choices for myself. My mom was making the choices, and she was like the remote control. Like, if I want to control this car, I'd use the remote control. I would tell it to go left, go right, whatever. Well, that's how I was kind of growing up. Now, my mom didn't control me like that, but she led me. She disciplined me. She taught me how I should live, how to obey rules, where to wake up, all those kind of things, right? But part of her job was to teach me that. So one day, I get the remote control. I get the remote control, mama, to my own life. I get to have the remote control and control my life. And that's what self-discipline is. Self-discipline is teaching you or your ability to control your own life. Here's a short word for it. Self-control. Remote control, self-control. Can you say self-control? I'm pretty sure you can say self-control, but self-control is so important. And I believe it's so important for us to learn how to discipline ourselves, because the truth is, many of you at this age are tired of people telling you what to do. Thing is, you must learn the appropriate way to act, obeying rules, doing what you're supposed to do. The definition of responsibility I like is this: taking care of your business. Taking care of your business or business. Another way to say it is this: taking ownership of your words and your actions. Taking ownership that you own it, like we talked about the remote control, that you take ownership. So responsibility and self-discipline, self-control kind of all work together. You're training yourself to do what you're supposed to do. All of us don't want to do some things, but we all want to become something. One artist said it this way: we don't want to squeeze, but we want the juice. I thought, what are they talking about? Let's say for an orange, for example, everybody wants to drink orange juice, but people don't want to go through the work of squeezing the orange to get the juice. Well, if you want the best life you can have, you gotta make some choices to squeeze the juice, to squeeze the orange, to do the work. So put it this way: self-discipline is doing what you should do so you'll become the person you want to become. Doing what you should do, doing what you know you should do so you'll become the person you want to become. Whether that's homework, whether that's in the sport, activities, whatever it is, doing what you're supposed to do. Now, I've grew up playing basketball, football, and I had a lot of people I looked up to that were athletes, professional athletes. And I'd be like, when we play basketball, we call the name, like we shoot a shot and be like, Jordan, or you know, Magic, and we do all that stuff, right? But I think about those athletes, they had to discipline themselves so they can be that great. They had to eat a certain diet, meals. They had to work out all the time. They had to come to practice and do the same thing over and over and over and over and over again. And honestly, it can be boring. But what they did it for, they looked at the end goal. They looked at the outcome. And they had to discipline themselves so they can get their reward. And that's the same thing for me and you in life. You may not ever be a professional basketball player, but I don't see why you shouldn't try. If you like basketball, try your best. But whatever you do in life is gonna take some self-discipline, some self-control, so you can be the person you wanna become. And it's a choice. And when you make better choices, you will live a better life. So choose well, choose responsibility. I choose responsibility and choose self-discipline so you can take the remote control of your own life and be the best you can be. Does that make sense? Say, oh yeah.
That has been Panther Pause. Remember, stay Panther proud and have a good weekend.